Now, the question number one. Tanks A and B open at top contains two different liquids up to certain height in them. A hole is made to the walls of each tank at a depth h from the surface of the liquid. The area of the hole in B is twice than that in A. If the liquid mass flux through each hole is equal, then the ratio of the densities of the liquids respectively is how much? So first of all, to answer this one, first of all, we will draw the diagrams. So this is tank A, and here this is tank B. So both are filled with two different liquids having the densities rho 1 and rho 2 at different depths. Different depths are nothing but this is height h1 and this is height h1 and h2. Then afterwards, a hole is made to the walls of each tank. So for this tank A and tank B, making two holes from the surface of the liquid. So here surface, here we are making one hole. This is the hole 1, and from the surface here we are making one hole at this particular point. And what happens in this case, this hole 2 is 2 times to the size of hole. That means the hole of the tank B is 2 times to the hole of tank 1. So that means here area of the hole increases, means what happens in this case particularly, velocity changes. So that means first of all, given the area of hole in B is twice than that of hole in A. So that's why A1 is equal to A, A2 is equal to 2A. But here velocity V1, so the water which must be gushes out from these holes. So here I will take V1, here I will take V2. So that's why V1 not equal to V2. So here from equation of continuity, I will write here A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. Now I will substitute. A1 means what is that? A. But what is V1 here? I will take V1. But area what happens? 2A and V2. A gets cancelled. But V2 is equal to V1 by 2. So that means velocity from the hole B is decreases. But one thing they give. If the liquid mass flux through each hole is equal. So that means what is liquid mass flux? First of all, we will calculate. Liquid mass flux means is equal to mass of fluid divided by time. So that means mass means what is that? Volume into density divided by time. But volume means what is that? Area into height into density divided by t. So that means area into density into height by time. So this is nothing but speed, A into rho into V. But here what is given here? Liquid mass flux through each hole is equal. So that means what happens here? A1 rho 1 V1, A2 rho 2 V2. Now substitute in this case, rho 1 divided by rho 2 is equal to A2 divided by A1 into V2 divided by V1. So here rho 1 divided by rho 2 is equal to 2A by A into V2 means V1 divided by 2 divided by V1. AA cancel, V1, V1 cancel, 2, 2 cancel. So rho 1 divided by rho 2 is equal to 1. Now what is the option for this one? Option A is the correct. Now the question number 2. A water barrel having water up to a depth D is placed on a table of height H. A small hole is made on the wall of the barrel at its bottom. If the stream of water comes out of the hole, falls on the ground at a horizontal distance or from the barrel, then the value of D is how much? So first of all, according to the question, we will draw the diagram. So on the table, there is a barrel of water which must be kept at a depth, that is D, and this must be placed on a table of height how much here, that is the height H. So there is a hole which is present at the bottom of the barrel. The water which must be comes out from the barrel and falls on the ground at a distance R, that is horizontal range. So this water barrel which is present on the table is at height at H. Now which one we want to calculate here? That is the horizontal distance we want to calculate. That means, and then the value of D we want to calculate, this D required. So for at this particular cases, how much amount of velocity which must be comes the water? Velocity is equal to square root over 2G into D. So whatever the depth is there, that should be multiplied. V is equal to root 2G and D. Now the water which must be comes like a projectile. So that's why by projectile motion of water, H is equal to ut plus half at square. So that means H is equal to 0 plus half gt square, and t is equal to square root over 2h by g, this one. But I want to calculate which one here. Range is required. Range r is equal to horizontal velocity into time. So that is root 2g into d, square root over 2h by g. So here 2 into 2, 4, I will take 2 outside. Then what happens in this case? Gg gets cancelled, 2 root d into h, but here r. But which one we want to calculate? D required. So that's why squaring on both sides. So that means what happens here? R square is equal to 4 into d into h, but here d is equal to r square by 4h. So now what is the option for this one here? R square by 4h, c is the option. Now the question number 3. A glass capillary tube of inner diameter 0.28 millimeters is lowered vertically into water in a vessel. The pressure to be applied on the water in the capillary tube so that water level in the tube is same as that in the vessel, that is the Newton by meter square, is how much? Surface tension of water is given 0.07 Newton by meter. Atmospheric pressure is given 10 to the power of 5 Newton by meter square. So first of all, which one we want to calculate in this particular aspect? That is pressure required. So that means what is the pressure? So first of all, what are the given parameters? That is first of all, inner diameter of capillary tube. Inner diameter of capillary tube D is equal to 0.28 millimeter, but radius is equal to D by 2, that is 0.28 by 2 millimeters, 0.14 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meters, convert into meters. Then afterwards, surface tension T is given 0.07 Newton by meter, and here atmospheric pressure 10 to the power of 5 newton by meter square. But here we know the formula. What is that? Surface tension T is equal to R into HdG divided by 2 cos theta. But in this case, what is given here? The pressure to be applied on the water in the capillary tube so that the water level in the tube is same as that in the vessel. So that means theta is equal to 0. Substituting theta is equal to 0, T is equal to R into H into D into G divided by 2 cos 0. So that means T is equal to R into H into D into G divided by 2. Cos 0 is equal to 1. But here H DG, that means H DG, D is nothing but density. H density into G is nothing but R into pressure divided by 2. But which one I want to calculate? Pressure. P is equal to 2 into T divided by R. But here total pressure required. Total pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus whatever the pressure here, this pressure. So that means atmospheric pressure 10 to the power of 5, but this pressure 2T divided by R. So 10 to the power of 5 plus 2 into 0.07 divided by R is nothing but 0.14 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So here 10 to the power of 5 plus 2 into this one 0.14 into 10 to the power of plus 3 divided by 0.14. Both gets cancelled. Here both gets cancelled. 10 to the power of 5 can be written as 10 square into 10 to the power of 3 plus 10 to the power of 3. Here 10 to the power of 3 common, 10 square is nothing but 100, here plus 1 is equal to 100 into 10 to the power of 3 newton by meter square. So this is the solution for this one. So which option is correct here? 100 plus 1, that is 101 into 10 to the power of 3. So option D is correct. Now the question number 4. The Poisson's ratio of a material is 0.4. If a force is applied to the wire of this material, there is a decrease of cross-sectional area by 2%. The percentage area in length is how much? So first of all, what is given here? Poisson's ratio. So here Poisson's ratio, that is sigma is equal to 0.4. And then afterwards, decrease in cross section area is equal to 2%. But here, which one we want to calculate here? Percentage increase in length required. So that's why we now here area of wire A is equal to pi r square. So this one I will take as an error here. dA divided by A is equal to pi is constant value. R square can be written as 2 times dr by r. But I will take delta A divided by A is equal to 2 times delta r divided by r. So that means what happens here? Delta A divided by A, that is how much change? That is 2%. Is equal to 2 times delta R by R, both gets cancelled. So delta R by R is equal to 1. So here we know this value, but which one we want to calculate here? That is change in length. So that's why Poisson's ratio delta, that sigma is equal to delta R by R divided by delta L by L. So that means here delta L by L is equal to delta R by R into 1 by sigma. So already we calculated delta R by R is 1. So that's why 1 into 1 by 0.4 is equal to 10 by 4 is equal to 2.5. So that means percentage increase is equal to 2.5%. So what is the option here? Bombay. B. Now the question number 5. If the displacement x and velocity v of a particle executing simple harmonic motion are related through 4v square minus 25 minus x square, then time period is how much? So options are given like that. So first of all, given values, what are those? That means displacement is equal to x and velocity is equal to v. That is the given values. Then afterwards here, SHM are related as. So what is the relation here? Particle executes simple harmonic motion, 4v square is equal to 25 minus x square. So first of all, we will take here differentiate on both sides. So that means d by dt of 4v square, d by dt of 25 minus x square. So on differentiating that, 4 into 2v dv by dt is equal to, here constant value 0, minus 2x into dx by dt. So we know that dv by dt is nothing but acceleration, and dx by dt is nothing but velocity. So I will write like this. 4 into 2v means what is that here? 8v into acceleration is equal to minus 2x into velocity. So in both the cases, here v and here v cancel. So what is that here in this case? 8a is equal to minus 2x. So that here 8a is equal to minus 2x. So that can be written as 4a is equal to minus x. But here a is equal to minus x by 4. But actually acceleration in simple harmonic motion is minus omega square x minus x by 4. X cancel, minus minus cancel here. Omega square is equal to 1 by 4. But here omega means what is that here? Time period. Omega is equal to 2 pi by t whole square. Omega square is equal to 1 by 4, but here 2 pi by t is equal to 1 by 2. But here I want to calculate time period. T is equal to 2 2s are 4, that's why 4 pi second. So what is the option here? Option C is the correct one. Now the question number 6. A body executes simple harmonic motion under the action of force F1 with a time period 4 by 5 seconds. If a force is changed to F2, it executes simple harmonic motion with the time period 3 by 5 seconds. If both the forces F1 and F2 act simultaneously in the same direction on the body, its time period in seconds is how much? So first of all, a body executing simple harmonic motion under the action of force F1. So that means under the action of force F1, time period T1 is equal to 4 by 5 seconds. Under the force F2, that is T2, time period is equal to 3 by 5 seconds. So simultaneously F1 and F2 together it is acting on the body. So now what is the time period? To calculate this one, first of all, body executing simple harmonic motion towards that force is MR omega square, centripetal force, that is equal to m into r into omega is nothing but 2 pi by t whole square f. So f is inversely proportional to t square. This is the main important condition. Now here, as two forces acting simultaneously means that is at a time, that is f is equal to f1 plus f2. So f is nothing but 1 by t square. That means f1 plus f2 is nothing but f, that is t, 1 by t square and 1 by t1 square and 1 by t2 square. On solving of this one, t is equal to t1 t2 divided by square root over t1 square plus t2 square. Now here t is equal to, that is 4 by 5 into 3 by 5 divided by square root over 4 by 5 whole square plus 3 by 5 whole square. So here 4 into 3, 12 divided by 25 and square root over 16 by 25 and 9 by 25. Here 12 by 25 divided by square root of 16 plus 9, 25 by 25. This is becomes 1. So the answer is 12 by 25 seconds. So what is the option here? 12 by 25 seconds. This is the solution for question number 6. Now the question number 7. A body is projected up with a velocity equal to 3 by 4th of escape velocity from the surface of Earth. The height it reaches is, radius of the Earth is equal to R. Now to solve this question, first of all I will take, this is the Earth surface. The mass of the Earth I will take as capital M, here Earth. Here Earth surface, initially the body which is present at this place, the mass of the body is taken as M, and radius of Earth, that I will take as capital R, that is given. When this body is projected with some amount of velocity, that is velocity of projection, this velocity of projection is 3 by 4th of escape velocity. That means velocity of projection is less. So that means what happens here, after projecting that, it reaches to some particular height. Some particular height. That height from the surface, I will take as, that is h. But from here to here, from radius of, from the center of Earth to here, that R is equal to h plus capital R, or otherwise R is equal to capital R plus h. That we have to remember. This body will move like this. That means projecting velocity is equal to 3 by 4th of escaping velocity. So here, first of all, given velocity of projection is equal to 3 by 4th of escape velocity. So here escape velocity is equal to square root over 2 capital G capital M divided by R. So that means velocity of projection is equal to 3 by 4 times root over capital G capital M divided by R. This is the given value. Now, which one we want to find here? That is, a body is projected up with a velocity equal to 3 by 4th of escape velocity from the surface of Earth. The height it reaches, that means where this body reaches here, this height required. This height is required, where the body reaches to there. So, to calculate that one, apply law of conservation of energy. So that means what happens here? Total energy at surface is equal to total energy at height. Total energy at height. So that means total energy at this particular point and total energy at this particular point. Total energy means what is that? Potential energy plus kinetic energy. This is initial, and potential energy plus kinetic energy, that is final. So first of all, potential energy initial, kinetic energy initial, potential energy final plus kinetic energy final. So first of all, I will take this potential energy. Potential energy at this particular place, capital G capital M small m divided by R, plus kinetic energy, half m velocity of projection whole square, is equal to potential energy at the final. That means potential energy at the final means what is that here at this particular point? Minus capital G capital M small m divided by R plus h. Why? Because this is the distance from here to here. And plus kinetic energy at the maximum height, that is at total height where it is, that must be, that is becomes zero. Now what happens in this case? Minus capital G capital M small m divided by r plus half m velocity of projection square. Means what is that here? Velocity of projection is 3 by 4 2 root gm by r. So that means 3 by 4 square root over 2 capital G m by r whole square. That means velocity of projection whole square is equal to minus capital G capital M small m divided by r plus h. Now here on simplification of this, minus capital G capital M small m divided by r plus half m whole square means 9 divided by 16 into 2 capital G capital M divided by r is equal to minus capital G capital M small m divided by r plus h. Is r plus h equation like this. Now afterwards here 2 and here 2. Now I am writing the equation what you get in the previous one. Now I will write like this, minus G M M divided by r plus here 2 and 2 gets cancelled. So what is the remaining here? 9 by 16 into capital G capital M small m divided by r is equal to minus capital G capital M small m divided by r plus h. By taking LCM here, 16 r minus 16 capital G capital M small m plus 9 capital G capital M small m is equal to minus G M capital M small m divided by r plus h. So here minus 7 capital G capital M small m divided by 16 r is equal to minus capital G capital M small m divided by r plus h. Here both sides cancel, minus minus becomes plus. 7 by 16 r is equal to 1 by r plus h. Cross multiplication, 7 r plus 7 h is equal to 16 r. 7 h is equal to 16 r minus 7 r. H is equal to 9 r by 7. So 9 r by 7 is the answer. Now in this question, what is the option here? Option B is the correct. Now the question number 8. If A is the aerial velocity of the planet of mass m, its angular momentum is how much? So here the planets which are revolving in the space in a long elliptical orbits, but here given, which one is given here? Aerial velocity of planet, that is equal to A. So whenever we are taking the long elliptical orbit like this, major axis and minor axis, the planet which sweeps equal intervals of equal intervals of time. So this is the radius capital R, and here this is makes an angle theta, that is d theta, and here this is R into d theta. So here I will take this is O, and this is the position A, and this is the position B. Now here I want to find this area. So that means area A is equal to half into base into height. So that means area is equal to half into base is nothing but how much here? R into d theta into height, that is radius, that I will take as R. So that means A is equal to half into R square into d theta. dA divided by dt is equal to half into R square into d theta by dt. So what happens here? dA divided by dt is equal to half into R square into d theta by dt is nothing but omega. So that means what happens in this case? Area is equal to half R square omega. But it should be multiplied by m on both sides. Both sides. But which one we want to calculate here? Angular momentum. So that's why m into a is equal to half into r square into omega into m. So that means m a is equal to half m r square omega. But since I is equal to m r square, so that's why m a is equal to half into I omega. So that's instead of m r square, I will write I here. But I omega is equal to angular momentum. So that means m a is equal to half into L. But I want to calculate which one here? Angular momentum. L is equal to 2 into m into a. So which option is correct here? B is the correct option. Now the question number 9. A body of mass m kg is on the top point of the smooth hemisphere of radius 5 meters. It is released to slide down the surface of the hemisphere. It leaves the surface when the velocity is 5 meters per second. At this instant, the angle made by the radius vector of the body with the vertical is how much? Acceleration due to gravity is taken as 10 meters per second. So first of all, what are the given values here? So velocity is equal to 5 meters per second and acceleration due to gravity 10 meters per second square, and the radius of the hemisphere that is taken as 5 meters. Now first of all, according to this question, I will draw the diagram. So how that must be? It is the hemisphere like this. So initially this is the hemisphere with the radius. I will take this radius as 5 meter. First, initially the body of mass capital M, which must be placed on the top of that one hemisphere, then it is allowed to fall in this particular direction at one particular point. This is the one particular point. That point I will take as A. At this particular point A, this body leaves the hemisphere. So that means what happens here? The body will leaves here means the entire weight of the body acting in the downward direction, and here towards the center there it will be mg. No, this is theta means mg cos theta, and here the normal reaction I will take as here n is the normal reaction, and the body which must be moves in this direction, this one we will take as mg sin theta. So these are the particular free body diagram for this question. Now first of all, what happens here? Let us suppose particle leaves the hemisphere at point A. So particle is nothing but body. So leaves at point A. Then what happens in this case? At this particular point, I will write the vertical here. That is mg cos theta minus n. But it must be moving toward the center. That is equal to m v square by r, that is centripetal force. So in this case, what happens here? When body leaves, means normal reaction is equal to 0 at point A. So that means here normal reaction 0 means mg cos theta is equal to m v square by r. M cancel, cos theta is equal to v square by rg. So here cos theta is equal to v square means what is that? 5 into 5 divided by r, that is 5 into 10. 155 cancel. So here 1 by 2. So that means cos theta is equal to cos 60 degrees. Dropping cos theta is equal to 60 degrees. At which angle the body leaves from the hemisphere? 60 degrees. So which is the option correct here? C. Now the question number 10. Moment of inertia of uniform solid cylinder of mass m about an axis passing through its edge and perpendicular to the axis of the cylinder when its length is 6 times to its radius r is how much? So here, first of all, here we will take the uniform solid cylinder. I will take this radius is r and length of the uniform solid cylinder I will take L, and it is the center of mass. The moment of inertia through the center of mass I will take as I, center of mass, and here we want to calculate the moment of inertia about an axis passing through its edge and perpendicular to the axis of rotation. So it is the edge. So this one I will take as AB. So IAB. So first of all, we will calculate I, center of mass, is equal to M L square divided by 12 plus M R square by 4. So moment of inertia through the center of mass is this one. Now here I want to calculate according to parallel axis theorem moment of inertia through AB, one edge of the uniform cylinder, is equal to I center of mass plus mr square. So I center of mass is nothing but ml square divided by 12 plus mr square divided by 4 plus mr square. So in this case, ml square divided by 12 plus mr square divided by 4 plus m into r is nothing but how much here? That is, from this to the center of mass I will take as L by 2. So that means L by 2 whole square is nothing but L square by 4. So this is the I, center of mass, to the through the AB. Now here, which one we want to calculate when its length is 6 times to the radius? So here, given length is equal to 6 times to the radius. Now substitute here. So moment of inertia towards the through the AB is equal to M L is nothing but 6 r whole square divided by 12 plus M r square divided by 4 plus M L is nothing but 6 r square divided by 4. So here 36 M r square divided by 12 plus m r square divided by 4 plus 36 m r square divided by 4. So here 3 12s are m r square divided by 4, that means 3 12s are 3 4s are. So then what happens here? 3 12s are 36, 3 4s are 12. 12 m r square by 4 plus m r square by 4 plus 36 m r square by 4. So out of all these ones, mr square by 4 as common, 12 plus 1 plus 36. So here 36, 37, here 49 mr square by 4. So which option is correct here? Option D is correct for this question.